immigration is a big issue for this country, and you see it also in Europe, migration from the Middle East to Europe, but we're also seeing it in Peru. We're seeing immigration coming from, Venezuela, the regime of Hugo Chavez and now Maduro, a lot of Colombians coming to Peru. Where do you see this? What is your interpretation? What the immigration is gonna, how's Peru gonna be in the future with this immigration influx? Is it gonna be accepted? Is it gonna be rejected? How do you see this as a, maybe futurist, if you will?
Well, there is a paranoia now with immigration, not only in the United States, all over the world. In Europe is more or less the same. There are this idea, which is completely false, it's wrong, that the immigrants come to the countries and they take jobs from the nationals because they accept any kind of salary. Immigrants are criminals, as President Trump said, remember? Criminals, they come to rape women, they are drug traffickers. All this is stereotypes. These are very ancient stereotypes. The idea that if a country has problems, the problems are brought for the other, for people who don't have the same gods that we have, for people who don't speak the same language that we do, people that don't have the same uses that we do. If there is a country which is a living contradiction of this prejudice, is United States. United States is a country of immigrants. Immigrants have transformed this country in the extraordinary country that it is. So if there is a country in the world in which the idea of the immigrant should be very positive, enthusiastically positive, is United States, All the sociologists, all the surveys that have done, and there are so many, demonstrating it, inequivocal terms that immigrants give countries much more than what received from them. And United States is a fantastic example of this. So, on the other hand, immigrants are not stupid people. They are humble, poor people in many cases, but they are not stupid. They don't go where they are needed. They go where they are needed. Because people, a country that progressed, that are civilized, means, this is something that means that many people are not ready anymore to do certain kind of jobs and provide certain kind of services. And these are the voids that the immigrants come to fill, to fulfill. And all the economists, all without exception, from the left, from the right, say that first world countries need immigrants if they want to keep their high levels of life. This is an essential necessity for developed countries. So we must fight these ridiculous prejudices against immigrants. Immigrants are poor people, yes. They are expelled from their countries for economic reasons, for political reasons. And they are paying us a great homage coming to our countries, because our countries represent civilization, democracy, tolerance, diversity, Well, these are the ideas that we must defend, and we must reject very energetically the prejudices against immigrants, because the prejudices against immigrants are the roots of all the monstrosities that have happened during our history. Nazism, fascism, communism have produced such massacres because of the prejudices against immigrants, against different races, against different religions. So we must fight the demagogy against the immigrants here in the United States, in Europe, and in all Latin American countries too, because racism is something that is deeply rooted in all countries, in all civilizations, but it's a very dangerous kind of roots out of which come wars, massacres, discrimination, the worst heritage of humankind. Thank you very much.